G'day all you beautiful people of planet Earth, and welcome to episode 11 of Planet Positivity. Without a teaser, you don't know what's coming up, and haven't I got a surprise for you? Honestly, when you think about going to Europe, there are certain countries that tend to come to mind for most people, and that was the case for me. So I was thinking France and Spain and Greece and Italy. And so when I actually got to Croatia, I didn't have any expectations. And what a blessing that was, because everything that I experienced, and I only went to one location, was absolutely incredible. You have to go to Croatia. Next best thing, I'll take you with me now. So when you go to a place like Croatia, you are guaranteed to be surprised in the most amazing ways. I cannot wait to take you for episode 11. Let's go to Croatia. Called Dubrovnik, which is a city in walls, and it's rich with history and has incredible beauty. So let me explore Dubrovnik with you. I honestly wish more than anything in the world that I got to experience and explore more than just one location in this amazing country, but I've got to be honest with you, this particular destination that we went in Croatia is uber famous. And if you're a Game of Thrones fan, you might recognize some of the places in a particular place called Dubrovnik. Which is a city in walls, and it's rich with history and has incredible beauty. So let me explore Dubrovnik with you. So Dubrovnik has the beautiful old town, which is a city within walls built during times of battle and things in the past. But they kept the beauty of that location and have, there's a very small community, a population that actually live in there. And I'll be honest with you, it was very expensive, but it was well worth it. If you get a chance to explore Croatia, Dubrovnik should be on your list. Because it's a city within walls, it's not a place you can get to without going through the entrance. And it is such an amazing entrance. That alone is a scene from Game of Thrones. I can't remember which one it was. You might recognize it. But as we walked in this beautiful night, there was classical music playing to just set the scene to this amazing place, rich with history and absolute beauty, and the feel that you get when you're there. You feel like you're stepping through time. It's so worth a visit. So there were two options for things for us to do this particular afternoon, and I think we only had like 2-3 days in Dubrovnik. And some people went for the Game of Thrones tour, and they were highlighting all the major places that we missed while we were walking around. We didn't really look for them, but when we found out what they were, we're wow. So the rest of us actually went on a kayaking tour and went out to sea and then found this amazing cave. People were jumping off the rocks. It was absolutely beautiful. And we got a bit of a history lesson en route to the cave. But that showed me a side of Dubrovnik I would never have known or looked for had I not done that, if I just stayed in the actual place itself. But thank goodness for people like Tegan, who actually went on the Game of Thrones tour. So she took a lot of photos that I can show you, because you know the shame part? Yeah, that was filmed there. I think it's Blackwater Bay, if that's the name of the place, is there. A lot of the entrances and the walkways are all parts of the Game of Thrones. location sets. So definitely worth seeing that if you're a big fan of Game of Thrones. Even if you're not, it's just interesting to see the history that made the place and then the history that was created in the place with a big show like that. When you go kayaking, it's amazing for the experience and the exercise, but when you have an amazing view of looking back, seeing the old town, seeing the mountains and the houses on the mountains, it really is absolutely beautiful, and it makes you feel a whole different vibe than when you're in actual old town of Dubrovnik. And I was lucky enough that a friend of mine who had his little ukulele was singing to me on the beach in the cave. So that was the most, oh, hello. Hey, buddy. So that was the most amazing time of the cave for me. Watching people jumping off the rocks was pretty cool. And I went rogue away from the crowd and climbed up a bit of the other side of the cliff and started having a conversation with the workers and having a laugh. It was just so good. And the water was so clear. That was probably my favorite part, how clear the water was and the fish. You could see the fish jumping up and down, and they gave me some bread, so I was feeding the fish, and oh, I just loved it. I wish I could go back there.
Oh, is that a shark? Oh, those did catch a shark. Oh, crazy, they're gonna go.
Like I said to you in the Greece episode, particularly Mykonos, the clubbing experience was awesome there, but wow. Croatia, honestly, I've never been to a rave, but that was what I imagine a rave would be. The entertainment they had on stage was absolutely fantastic. Crazy things, they had people dressed in different things, wearing stilts, playing with fire. The music was just awesome, and it was great vibes everywhere. And typical alley, I went rogue and separated from the crowd. I don't know how I got to the front, just where the stage was. And I was there for hours on my own. I think I got home the latest in our group, about 4 a.m. But yeah, meeting all these different random people, dancing and listening to music. It didn't matter if we didn't know each other. You were just connecting through the music. It was awesome. Ah. Thank you Croatia, and thank you Dubrovnik. Thank you for showing me how we can transform a negatively built place into a positive experience for the world. Thank you. Well, that's it for episode 11, and I'll see you soon. Bye, beautiful people.